Hi everyone. Today we're going to be building a customer support dashboard app. This app can be used by the CS teams to look up user information, update details, look through their order history, as well as refund different orders. So let's begin by actually getting some user data into our system. We've already set up the backend, so we just need to configure an API. We can call it getUsers. And we're using Postgres for our backend. So some of you might not be familiar with the syntax, but Postgres allows us to query our backend through an API-like format. We can add a limit query because we have a large amount of data on the backend. We can order the data by the ID field. We can make sure that we are only returning a select set of fields such as ID, name, email, address, avatar, and gender. We can also go ahead and hardcode the offset to 0 for now. So let's save this API. And just like that, we're able to actually fetch the data from our backend. Now we want to be able to visualize this information. So let's begin by using the widgets we have here. The container will allow us to group different widgets together. And we can give this container a title. So the property pane allows us to update the data of each of the widgets. We can also go ahead and give it certain styles. And since we're using a list of data such as get users, let's use a table to visualize it. The table can be really easily resized to make sure that it fits the data set. We can call this the users table. And right now the users table has only hard-coded information, but we can just as easily use the mustache-like syntax to say getUsers.data, and just like that we're able to fetch all the data from the API. Now we also want to be able to iterate over the entire data set because this is a paginated API. So let's go ahead and enable server-side pagination. And let's also say that on page change, we're going to call getUsers again. And we also want to be able to filter different users by their name. So let's add a search input. We can create the placeholder as search name. And we can say that every time the text changes, let's go ahead and call getUsers. Let's now update our API to reflect this. So right now our offset is hard-coded, but we can just as easily get the offset from the users table. We can reference the page number, but page numbers start from 1, so we have to subtract 1 since offsets start from 0, and we can go ahead and multiply it by the page size. We'd also like to add a filter on the name property, so let's use the ilike filter, and let's pass in the inputs text. So let's save this. And just like that, we're now able to iterate over the entire data set. We can also go ahead and search for a particular user's name and filter through the entire data set as well. But now we also want to be able to drill down and look at this user's data. For example, the avatar is only showed as a URL right now. So let's make use of the image widget. We can go ahead and reference the table's data, say users table dot selected row, and we can show the avatar that's in the selected row. So as soon as we select a user over here, we're able to see the information get updated over here. All the other fields have been updated likewise. Now let's try and update this user's data. Let's wire the onClick function, and let's call the update user API. And once that succeeds, let's go ahead and refresh the user data by calling it again. So now we can remove the last name from this person, and let's go ahead and update it. And just like that, we can see that the user's details got updated. Now let's see how we can fetch this user's order information. We've already gone ahead and created the order API, so on row select, let's just go ahead and call fetch orders. And just like that, on row select, we're able to also fetch order details. So Appsmith really makes it very easy to fetch details as well as update details in any kind of application. So we can also drill down on all the order information here. And now we want to be able to refund this order information. So let's try and create a refund button. We can call it refund. And we can style it very simply. And on click, let's go ahead and call the refund API. As well as on success, let's refetch the orders. Now, before we actually try this out, let's go ahead and publish this application. The publish mode makes it really easy for application handoff. So now this is the way that your end users would actually use this application. So here we can look at different users' order information and we can update their status. And with Appsmith, you can also control the access to your application. You can make sure that only certain users have access to view this application, as well as different users have access to edit this application. And just like that, within a few minutes, we are actually able to deploy a customer support dashboard. And that's what makes Appsmith really, really powerful.